Very good morning to all of you and a warm welcome to all of you. And wish a happy practical International Day of Yoga. Okay? Can anyone tell what is the theme for this year? What is the theme for this year? Anybody remember? Exactly right. Yoga for humanity. Okay? To improve our humanity, we have to relax our body and we have to calm down our mind. That is the, you know, basic step into, you know, improving humanity. So let us practice yoga today to relax our body and to calm down our mind so that, you know, afterwards we can improve our humanity. Right? There will be, you know, few stretchings, gentle stretchings, because all age group people are here, and there will be slow breathing pattern and, you know, lessening thoughts in the mind with consciousness. So today's session is, you know, modified version of protocol itself, but there will be few asanas, few pranayamas, few relaxations, meditation techniques, so that all of us, we practice. Okay? Right? So, two students will do the demonstration and, you know, you can look at them, you can continue your practice. Is it okay? Right. And this is, you know, a request for you. Whatever possible, you do only that part of it. If you have knee joint pain, if you have low back pain, if you have neck stiffness, you take care of that and just do whatever possible. Okay? Now let us start today's yoga practice. Just you stretch your legs, hands, sides of your body, look front, and breathe normally. First, let us do Swastikasana. Swastikasana is, you know, very good posture, very simple meditative posture to improve our overall health. Okay? Sit straight. Breathe normally. Breathe in. While breathing out, bend your left leg inside. Again, breathe in. While breathing out, bend your right leg inside. Put it on the left leg. Okay? Now hold your hands, chin mudra, on the knees, straight back and neck. Close your eyes. Go for normal breathing. Normal inhalation, complete exhalation. Slowly inhale, completely exhale. Open your eyes, breathing in, stretch your right leg, breathe out, breathing in, stretch your left leg, breathe out and relax. Okay? Next one is Vajrasana. Take care of your knee joint. Breathe in. While breathing out, bend your legs back and sit on the heels. Hands on your thighs. Straight back and neck, look front and breathe. Now hold your hands back, breathe in. While breathing out, slowly go on bending forward. Do whatever possible, bend your neck, close your eyes, slow breathing. Breathing in, slowly come up. breathe out, release your hands, hands on your thighs. Breathing in, stretch your legs straight. Once again, sit in Samasthiti. Look front and breathe. Vajrasana is very good for the knee joints and back and neck. Next, standing practices. All of you stand. With joined legs, look front and breathe. Look front and breathe. Next one is Parivrita Tadasana. Interlock your fingers with joined legs. Breathing in, stretch your hands above the head. Now, breathing out, turn to back from right side. Turn to back above the waist region. Look at your hands and breathe normally. Look at your hands and breathe normally. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathing out, turn back from left side. Look at your hands. Slow breathing. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathing out, put your hands down. Stand in Samasthiti. Parivrita Tadasana is very good for the back and neck and shoulders. Now let us practice Trikonasana. Join your legs. Breathing in, stretch your right leg to right side. About one leg distance with stretched hands on both the sides. Okay. Now turn your right foot to right side. Breathing out, go on bending towards right leg. Hold the right leg wherever possible. Look at the left hand, which is straight up. Normal inhalation and exhalation. Both knee joints should be straight. Breathing in, slowly come up. Turn your foot. Now left foot to left side. Breathing out, bend towards left side. Hold your left leg wherever possible. Look at the right hand, which is straight up. Slow breathing. Breathing in, slowly come up. Turn your left foot to front. Breathing out, join your right leg to left. Stand in Samasthiti. Look front and breathe. Next one is Parshvakonasana. Little, you know, different than this. Once again, breathing in, right leg to right side. Stretch your hands on both the sides. Now turn your right foot to right side. Now breathing out, bend your right knee about 90 degrees. Right hand down on the ground. Left hand towards right. Left hand towards right. Look at your left hand and breathe normally. Very good. Look at your left hand, which is on the right side. Now breathing in, come up. Turn your right foot to front. Now turn your left foot to left side. Breathing out, bend your left knee about 90 degrees. Left hand down on the ground. Right hand towards left side. Look at the left hand and breathe slowly. Look at the left hand and breathe slowly. Breathing in, come up, turn your foot. Breathing out, join your right leg to left. Look front and breathe. Trikonasana and Parshvakonasana, what you have practiced right now, very good for the knee joints, ankle joints, hip joints, as well as shoulder joints. Okay, now breathing in, join your hands above the head. Breathing out, go on bending front. Bend your head, close your eyes, normal breathing. Don't hurt your back. Knee joint should be straight. Breathing in slowly, take your hands, join them above the head. Breathing out, put your hands down, look front and breathe. Paschimottanasana or intense forward bending will remove the excess fat in the belly and improves the back and shoulders, right? Now Purvottanasana, place your hands 1 foot back, exactly 1 foot back, wrist joints as it is. Now breathing in, lift your body up off the ground, look back and breathe. Stretch your toes towards the ground, look back and breathe. Excellent. Breathing out slowly, come down. Place your hands to front. This asana improves your ankle joints, wrist joints, back and neck. Next one is Janu Shirshasana. Okay, breathe in. While breathing out, bend your left leg inside, heel pressing the root of the right thigh. Now stretch it back about 120 degrees. Stretch it back about 120 degrees. Right? Now breathing in, join your hands above the head. Breathing out, go on bending towards right knee. Bend your head, close your eyes, normal breathing. Just bend up to your ability and breathe normally. Now breathing in slowly, come up, look at your hands. Breathing out, place your hands down. Breathing in, stretch your left leg. Same practice on the right side. Breathing out, bend your right leg, stretch it back about 120 degrees. Now breathing in, stretch your hands above the head. Breathing out, go on bending towards left knee. Bend your neck, close your eyes, normal breathing. Breathing in slowly, come up, join your hands above the head. Breathing out, place your hands down. Breathing in, stretch your leg, breathe out and relax. Janu Shirshasana is very good for the reproductive organs, excretory organs and digestive organs, as well as for the knee joints, right? Okay, now lie down on your back, relax and breathe. Legs apart, open hands on both sides, adjust your places, adjust your place, close your eyes, normal breathing. Normal breathing. Join your legs, open eyes. Now breathe in, breathing out, bend your right leg on the chest, hold it by both hands. Now breathing in, lift your head up, look at the knee joint and breathe normally. Other knee should be straight. Breathing out, place your head down. Breathing in, stretch your leg. Breathe out and relax. Okay? Now, left leg. Breathing out, bend your left leg. Bring it close to your chest. Breathing in, come up. Look at your knee and normal breathing. Breathing out, place your head down. Breathing in, stretch your leg. Relax and breathe. Now both the legs. Breathing out, bend your legs. Bring them close to your chest. Breathing in, come up. Look at your knee. Normal breathing. Breathing out, place your head down. Breathing in, stretch your legs. Breathe out and relax. Pavanamuktasana is very good for the digestive functions and for the back and neck. Okay? Now Padottanasana, join your legs. Place your hands exactly at the level of your shoulders. Palms facing down. Palms facing down. Stretch them at the level of your shoulders. Now breathing in, lift your right leg straight up. Look at your leg. Normal breathing, shoulders relaxed, slowly breathe in and breathe out. Now breathing out, place your right leg down, okay? Now left leg, breathing in, lift your left leg, look at the leg, shoulders relaxed, breathe normally. Head down on the ground. Breathing out, put your leg down. Now both the legs, breathing in, lift the legs up. Try to put them straight. Look at your legs, slow breathing. Breathing out, place your legs down, hands also down, legs apart, close your eyes, relax and breathe. Padottanasana improves your venous circulation, so very good for your legs and abdominal functions. Okay, now join your legs, lie down on your stomach. Lie down on your stomach, hands below your face, face to any side, close your eyes and breathe. Adjust your places, close your eyes, normal breathing. Makarasana is a relaxation posture. By the practice of this Makarasana will improve the relaxation of body and mind. Normal breathing. Now join your legs. Next one is Bhujangasana. Place your hands exactly below the shoulders. Exactly below the shoulders. Okay? Join your feet. Now breathing in, lift your body. Face, neck up. Look up. Normal breathing. Look up. Normal breathing. Breathing out, slowly come down. Once again, hands below your face, relax and breathe. Next one is Shalabhasana. Place your hands exactly below the thighs, hands below the thighs. Now breathing in, lift your legs straight up, face and neck up, look up and normal breathing. Breathing out, put your head down, legs down, release your hands, lie down as before and relax. Next one is Dhanurasana. Bend your legs up, hold them at ankles if possible, then only do it. Hold them at ankles. Now breathing in, lift your face, chest up. Try to look up and slow breathing. Very good. Slow breathing. Breathing out, put your head down. Breathing in, stretch your legs. Hands as before, close your eyes, relax and breathe. Bhujangasana, Shalabhasana and Dhanurasana improves all these three practices are, improve your back and neck. Now all of you sit down, all of you sit down. So today we are not able to practice all those asanas, but again you have practiced few standing postures, few sitting postures, few prone position postures and few supine position postures, where you have also done forward bendings, backward bendings, side bendings and rotations. Right. Next is about the pranayama practices. Let us practice one or two pranayama techniques. Okay, stretch your legs. Now sitting swastikasana, breathe in while breathing out, bend your left leg inside. Again breathing, breathing out, bend your right leg, place it on the left, back and neck straight, hands on the knee joints, chin mudra, close your eyes, normal breathing. First one is Anuloma Viloma Pranayama. Open eyes. Right hand hold Mrigiya Mudra, forefinger and middle finger are bent inside. Close your right nose using the thumb. Breathe in through the left, close it, breathe out through the right. Now breathe in through the right, close it, breathe out through the left. This is one round. Breathe in through the left, breathe out through the right. Breathe in through the right, breathe out through the left. Close your eyes. Slowly go on doing this pranayama. Breathe in slowly, breathe out completely through the other nostril. Breathe in slowly through the same nostril. Breathe out completely through the other nostril. Observe each inhalation and exhalation. Go on breathing.
breathe out through the right, breathe in through the right and breathe out through the left. This is one round of Anuloma Viloma Pranayama. Breathe out through the left nostril and stop the practice. Release your hand. Anuloma Viloma Pranayama regulates the breathing pattern or the respiration. Also, it regulates thermal mechanism or thermal physiology in the body. And slowdown of breath rate will relax your mind, as there will be decrease in the thoughts in the mind. Okay. Now, Surya Bedana Pranayama, breathing only through the right nostril to enhance energy levels in the body, right? Or prana functions in the body. So, once again, your right hand hold Pragya Mudra as you have practiced in Anuloma Viloma Pranayama, okay? Right. Now, close your left nose with ring finger and little finger. Left hand hold Chin Mudra. Close your eyes. Breathe slowly in and out only through the right nostril. No sound, no force. Shoulders relaxed. Breathe in slowly, breathe out completely, only through right nostril. Close your eyes, observe your each inhalation and exhalation. The breath rate slow downs. Breathing becomes rhythmatic. Breathing becomes diaphragmatic or abdominal. Results in conscious breathing. Completely involve with your inhalation and exhalation. Slow inhalation, complete exhalation. You should be able to hear very, very clear sound and observe the sound. Slow inhalation and produce the sound as long as possible. Completely involved with the sound. Left hand on the chest, right on the stomach, shoulders down on the ground. Normal inhalation and exhalation. Observe your breathing movements through the palms. Observe your breathing movements through the palms. If any thought comes, again come back to the breathing movement and observe your breathing movement. Slow inhalation and complete exhalation. Stomach moves slowly up and down. Keep on observing it. Slowly open your eyes, put your hands down, turn to a side and get up. Turn to a side and get up. Now let us practice meditation for only 2 minutes. While breathing in, mentally pronounce so. While breathing out, mentally pronounce hum. So hum, so hum meditation. Breathing in, mentally pronounce so. Breathing out, mentally pronounce hum. Go on doing it. So and hum. Soham is, the universal self is existing within me. Meditation practice will improve the perception, focus, memory power and concentration, and improves neural conductivity and releases happy hormones, and we become relaxed and fresh. Open eyes. Open eyes. Breathing in, stretch your right leg. Breathe out, breathing in, stretch your left leg. So today we have practiced gentle stretchings as asana practice, slow breathing pattern as pranayama practice, shavasanas as relaxation practice, and soham dhyana is as meditation practice. This is not a complete session of, you know, yoga practice. This is just an awareness program so that you can learn further, come to our division, and you can practice regularly to improve physical relaxation, calmness of the mind, and to enhance humanity, right? That is the theme. Thank you once again to all of you from, you know, various colleges, the staff and students, as well as other, you know, faculty members. You came for the practicing session, and, you know, thanks a lot to you. I wish, and also I suggest, practice yoga regularly, regularly and regularly. Thank you once again.
योगेन चित्तस्य पदेन वाचां मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोतं प्रवरं मुनीनां पतञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिं आनतोऽस्मि. अ प्लेजेंट गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वॉर्म वेलकम टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर. कमिंग टुगेदर इज अ बिगिनिंग, कीपिंग टुगेदर is a progress, working together is a success. Yes, we are here together to celebrate the 8th International Day of Yoga. I request Dr. Annapurna K. and Dr. Satish Rao to escort the dignitaries to the dais. Thank you, sir. Nothing is impossible with our God as long as we have faith for His mighty power. As we march forward into the new year with a great hope and aspiration, let us invoke the blessing of God to be highly successful in all the ventures. I request all to be seated. I request the student of MSc Yoga Therapy to come on the dais for invocation.
शरणु सिद्धि विनायका, शरणु विद्या प्रदायका, शरणु पार्वती तनय मूर्ति, शरणु मूषक वाहना, शरणु 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 निटिल नेत्रन देवी सुतने नागभूषण प्रियने त्रटिल तांकित कोमलांगने कर्ण कुंडल धारने शरणु 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 ऊक्षिमहालंबोदरने इक्षुचापन गलिदने ಪಕ್ಷಿ ವಾಹನ ಸಿರಿ ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲನ ನಿಜ ದಾಸನೇ ಶರಣು 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 ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ವಿನಾಯಕ ಶರಣು ವಿದ್ಯ ಪ್ರದಾಯಕ ಶರಣು ಪಾರ್ವತಿ ತನಯ ಮೂರುತಿ ಶರಣು ಮೂಷಕ ವಾಹನ ಶರಣು 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 ಶರಣು
ವಾಟ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದ ಟಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಆಲ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ there are any locks on that door or any guards at the gate. I take this opportunity to call upon Dr. Vishal Bhatt, coordinator CIMR, to welcome the gathering.
Good morning, distinguished guests and dear friends. I am immensely pleased to welcome you on the occasion of the celebration of the 8th International Day of Yoga at Mahe, Manipal. 8 years ago, when our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, made the proposal to celebrate the 21st June as International Day of Yoga at the United Nations General Assembly, nobody had imagined that this will become one of the most popular and most celebrated international days declared by the United Nations. It is the power of yoga, its undeniable health benefits, its message of peace and harmony, and the love and commitment of all yoga practitioners that has made this International Day a huge success. It is my privilege and honor to welcome our chief guest for this day, an exceptional academician, an outstanding ENT surgeon, and an able administrator, Lieutenant General Dr. M.D. Venkatesh, Vice Chancellor Mahe Manipal, as our chief guest. A hearty welcome to you, sir. It is a joy to have with us a towering and endearing personality. It is lovely to see him year after year, cheering and inspiring our activities with great gusto. A delightful welcome to our Pro-Chancellor H.S. Barlal to this event. We have with us Dr. M. Venkatrai Prabhu, Pro-Vice-Chancellor Mahe, Dr. Narayan Sabahit, Registrar Mahe, and Dr. Sharad Kumar Rao, sir, Dean KMC Manipal. Dear friends, please join me in giving them the most cordial of welcomes. A gracious welcome to Dr. PLNG Rao, Pro Vice Chancellor, Mahe Manipal. Dr. Nali Bhaskaranana ma'am and Dr. Anis George ma'am, for your contributions to yoga therapy and yoga research, we extend an appreciative welcome to you to this event. A grateful welcome to Mrs. Indira Barlal for joining us today. I see among us the presence of various institutional heads of various divisions and departments of Mahe, and faculty members. A genial welcome to all of you. Thank you for coming here. The members of the press and the media have been instrumental in promoting the message of yoga to the general public. I offer a friendly welcome to you. And to all the participants during the yoga session in the morning today, many of you have made a huge effort to join us today. on behalf of us all at the Center for Integrative Medicine and Research, the Division of Yoga, Mahe Manipal, we are deeply appreciative and offer you our most grateful welcome. Yoga Karmashu Kaushadham, Aushadham. Yoga is excellence in action. My dear friends, I am positive that yoga will help shape your bodies and minds in a healthy and purposeful way. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, on behalf of the Division of Yoga, Center for Integrative Medicine and Research, I extend a sociable welcome to all of you on this occasion. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Annapurna K, HOD Division of Yoga, to give an overview of today's program.
Tam vidyat dukkha sanyoga viyogam yoga samjitam. Respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, all the staff and faculty members who are here, my dear students, a very good morning to all of you. Namaste. The concept of celebrating International Day of Yoga is to bring awareness about the right knowledge of yoga and practice. Today morning, we practiced yoga for humanity. That is the theme. Well, how yoga practice improves humanity? As yoga is an Indian philosophy, and many of us we practice to improve our physical and mental health. The core concept is transform ourselves from the animal being to human being, then to divine being with the serenity. As we practice asana, pranayama and dhyana for health, also we have to practice non-violence and truthfulness. Then all our responsibilities or karmas will convert into perfection. Yoga karmasu kaushalam. To control our violence and untruthfulness, we have to attain calmness of the mind. Manaha prashamana upayaha yoga ityabhidhiyate. Whenever we get thoughts of violence and untruth, then we have to bring an opposite thought, that is thought of kindness and telling the truth, and also to practice it to transform ourselves from animal being to human being with discipline, with dedication and with discrimination and devotion. The first verse of Yoga Sutra is mentioned, Atha Yoga Anushasanam. If we practice yoga as said in the literatures, we will get the told benefits. With this introduction, I would like to give a brief note on the programs which were held since past 2 months as per the protocol of UGC. Division of Yoga, Center for Integrative and Medicine Research, conducted summer yoga camp for children for 2 weeks and also free yoga sessions for the staff and students for 10 days. Conducted competitions such as yoga photo competition, asana, essay and poster. This year we got many entries from Mangalore KMC also. I do appreciate the support given by the students and staff of all the institutions of Mahe. I congratulate the prize winners. Organized webinar on dimensions and relevance of yoga therapy by Dr. Ishwara Basavareddy, Director Morarji Desai Institute of Yoga, New Delhi, Ministry of Ayush. Now, about the felicitation program to be held today. Dr. Nalini Bhaskaranand for the promotion of yoga therapy since 1985. Madam, if something is wrong, please do the correction and bless me. Over the years, Dr. Nalini Madam incorporated yoga therapy in 90% of pediatric patients. It was very difficult to convince to the parents and to the child about yoga. If the child is not able to learn, teach it to the mother, then she trains the child and make it possible. It was not possible, none other than you, madam. Over the years, we get continuous reference from the pediatric department, and since then, all other OPDs of Kasturba Hospital. Now also, Dr. Nalini Madam refers children to us from High Tech Hospital, Udupi. Madam, we are grateful to you for promoting yoga therapy. Namaste. Well, now about Dr. Anise George, Madam, for the promotion of research in yoga. She herself pursued her PhD in yoga. Since then, she guided many PhD scholars in yoga, also received many grants in yoga. Madam, we do appreciate your continuous efforts for encouraging and promoting research in yoga in your institution and also in other institutions. Namaste, Madam. Today, Mrs. Indira Ballal will do the felicitation to Dr. Nalini Bhaskaranam and Dr. Anise George, Madam. Mrs. Indira Ballal, Madam, Namaste. I am very glad and grateful for the support given by the university. Namaste, sir. The message I would like to give on this day, let us continue our practice of yoga to enhance our humanity and to live a simple lifestyle with kindness and serenity. Thank you and Namaste.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request our dignitaries to inaugurate the function by lighting the lamp. I request ma'am and Satish Rao sir to just guide. When I waste minutes, ask take revenge. I take immense pleasure to call our chief guest of today's function, Lieutenant General Dr. M.D. Venkatesh, Vice Chancellor Mahe Manipal, to please address the gathering.
Very good morning to everybody and warm greetings on this 8th International Yoga Day. Dignitaries on the dais, eminent personalities in the audience, heads of the institutions, heads, faculty from all institutions of Mahe, my dear students and guests. The practice of yoga is believed to have started with the very dawn of civilization. The science of yoga has its origin thousands of years ago. Yoga is essentially a spiritual discipline, also a science of healthy living. As per the yoga scriptures, the practice of yoga leads to the union of individual consciousness with that of the universal consciousness, indicating a perfect harmony between the mind, body, and soul. According to modern scientists, everything in the universe is just a manifestation of the same quantum firmament. Thus, the aim of yoga, of self-realization, to overcome all kinds of sufferings leading to a state of liberation or freedom, living in all walks of life, health and harmony shall be the main objectives of yoga practice. There's a lot of reference to yoga even in our scriptures. The most famous amongst them is Bhagavad Gita, where there's a shloka which says, I quote, Yoga Jnanam Tata Sankhyam Vidya Shilpadi Karmacha Veda Shastrani Vijnanam Etat Sarvam Janardhanat. In effect, it means that yoga is equated to all forms of knowledge, skills, and perhaps the easiest way to reach the God Almighty. That is the importance of yoga, which has been even written about or spoken about by Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. And coming to the today's event, which is perhaps one of the largest events which are conducted across the world as form in the form of International Yoga Day, duly recognized by the United Nations General Assembly. So 21st Yoga, 21st June of every year from 2015 is being practiced as International Yoga Day, and we must thank and pay our regards to our Honorable Prime Minister, who made this possible with a strong and purposeful presentation at the United Nations. Today, perhaps this is the most important event that is practiced close to 200 countries. People of all religions, all faiths, and even people who don't believe in any faith do practice yoga. And the advantages of yoga is multitude, from physical to mental stability to spiritual awareness, and more than anything else, its preventive aspects of many diseases has been supported by a lot of evidence, which is even today available in the scientific literature. In the General Assembly, Narendra Modi ji said, "Yoga is an invaluable gift of Indian ancient tradition. It embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, restraint and fulfillment, harmony between man and nature, a holistic approach to health and well-being. It's not about exercise, but to discover the sense of oneness with yourself, the world and nature. Changing our lifestyle and creating consciousness, it can help us deal with climate change. Let us work towards adapting an International Yoga Day." I'm very happy that today the Division of Yoga, Center for Integrative Medicine and Research, Mahe Manipal, is organizing this wonderful program. And I'm also very happy that as a prelude to this program, the Division of Yoga has been conducting a large number of programs in terms of initiating people into yoga, speaking about the advantages of yoga, and also today organizing, just before this, a mass yoga demonstration. I think I compliment Dr. Annapurna and the team for this excellent thought and activity which has occurred from last 2 years. This is what makes a difference, makes Mahe stand out among other universities, that there is a purpose for every action that the university takes. Once again, on this International Yoga Day, the 8th International Yoga Day, I offer my warm greetings to everyone present here, and I wish this function all the success and hope that this International Yoga Day gains more momentum, more and more people join this movement, and to make our mind and body clear, and our mind and body ready to accept the truth, and mind and body ready to do only good things in life and prevent illness and disability. Thank you very much, and Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir, for your excellent quote from Bhagavad Gita, and thank you for your continuous support. Our department has conducted yoga camp for children and various competitions on the behalf of International Day of Yoga. I request the winners to assemble on the left side of the hall. I request Dr. M. Venkataraya Prabhu, Pro Vice Chancellor, Faculty of Health Science, to hand over the prize to the winner. Third prize, Shweta Krishna. Second prize, Pritesh Shetty. First prize, Sushma Har. Sushma is absent. Take and bring it back. This was junior category. Sushma is absent. We'll go to the senior category. Consolation Prize, Asha. Vijayalakshmi. Revati Pishanai. Third prize, Shobhayam Prabhu. Second prize, Umananda KV. First prize, T. Narahari Pai. We'll go to the students group. Consolation prize, Pavitra BJ. Bhavna. Third prize, Mayuri. Second prize, Parameshwari. First prize, Bhavita. Thank you, sir. We'll move to essay competition. I request Dr. Narayan Sabahit to hand over the prize to the essay winners. Third prize, Sharada. Second prize, Bharati. First prize, Nisha Shetty. Poster competition. Third prize, Swati Shanai. Second prize, Shobha. First prize, Bharati R. Nayak. Thank you, sir. Photo competition. I request Dr. Sharath Kumar Rao, Dean, Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, to hand over the prize to the winner. Below 15 years category, third prize, Tulaja. Second prize, Anshetti. First prize, Maitreya. Okay, absent. Above 15 years, third prize, Vrinda Goswami. Second prize, Swati. First prize, Sushma R. Thank you, sir. Moving on to the felicitation program, it's my immense pleasure to call upon Dr. Nalini Bhaskarananda to the dais, and I request Dr. Annapurna K. to escort the guest. And I also request Mrs. Indira Ballal to do the honor. I request Dr. Krishna Hebbar, Division of Ayurveda, to give a brief introduction about the guest.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, and Mahe family. Dr. Nalini Bhaskarnand, Madam, completed her MBBS in 1975 from Karnataka Medical College, Hubli, secured the first rank in pharmacology. Completed her MD in pediatrics from Kasturba Medical College in 1980, joined as a faculty in the Department of Pediatrics in the same college in the 1981, and retired as a professor of pediatrics in July 2017. Currently working as a consultant pediatrician at Hitech Medicare Hospital, Udupi, interested in pediatrics, nephrology, and inborn errors of metabolism. Her merits and awards: Vaman Rao Kore Gold Medical Medal for standing first in obstetrics and gynecology in the university. V.R. Kasbekar of Ankola Gold Medal for standing first among ladies in the university. Hubli Medical Association Gold Medal for securing highest aggregate marks in MBBS course. Srimati Gangubai R. Patil of Arshinagodi Gold Medal for standing first in surgery among ladies in the Karnataka University. President Silver Medal for achieving the highest marks among women medical graduates in the university. Meena Silver Rolling Trophy for securing the highest marks in first, second, and third year MBBS degree. Yavagal Rolling Shield for the best outgoing student of the year 1975. Recipient of the Best Student of the Year Award by Karnataka Sangh of KMC Hubli on Rajyotsava Day in 1976. Married to Dr. Bhaskaranda Kumar, who is an orthopedic surgeon with special interest in the congenital and hand anomalies. She is blessed with a daughter who has completed her doctorate in engineering and working currently in the United States. And Madam has proved that if yoga therapy is incorporated with the contemporary medicine, there will be the better result. And as Patanjali said, Tatra Nirantra Drudha Bhumihi, she, Madam, is also used to persuade her patients to involve in continuous yoga practice. And every time when the patient visits our department, she asks to use the word, "Have you visited the yoga department? You just recheck your yoga practice." So this is not only the referring to yoga patient for the yoga department, it is the persuading the patient to involve in nirantara practice. That is the tatra nirantara drudha saivita drudha bhumihi. That means she made to her patient, and she proved that yoga therapy can be as a adjuvant therapy in many diseases along with the modern medicine. And she just involved the patient to undergo four levels of health, that is physical, mental, social, and spiritual health, by adopting the yogic lifestyle. And as yoga said, mana prashamanapa yogaha, which is very necessary in the today's world. And she is given the immense part in following the yoga practice, not only in the students as well as patients, in the general public also. On this occasion, with respect, we felicitate her incredible work in promotion of yoga therapy. We wish her to have a blissful and prosperous life. Thank you, one and all.
It's my immense pleasure to call upon Dr. Anis George to the dais, and I request Dr. Annapurna K to escort the guest. And I also request Mrs. Indira Balla to do the honor. I request Dr. Govardhan Reddy, Division of Yoga, to give a brief introduction about the guest.
Good morning, all. She is the first nursing professional to complete her PhD from Manipal Academy of Higher Education, Manipal. Her research was on the effect of yoga therapy in the management of dysmenorrhea. The study period was 1995 to 1998. This was the first systematic research in yoga conducted at Mahé, Manipal. She has also completed the 1 month residential yoga instructor course from the Vivekananda Yoga Research Center at Prashanthi Kutiram, Bengaluru in 1996. 5 students have received their PhD with her as the guide in topics related to various aspects of yoga. There are currently 3 funded projects on yoga being supervised by her at MCON. On completing her MPhil nursing from Rajkumari Amrut Kaur College of Nursing, Delhi University. Later, she joined the Manipal Group in 1991 as the vice principal of the college and was later elevated as the dean of the College of Nursing. After serving as the dean for a period of 14 years, she is currently working as a professor and head research and collaboration at MCON, Manipal. She has contributed immensely to the growth of the institution. She has over 130 publications to her credit and has delivered more than 90 talks on invite at professional conferences on various topics. The most valued accomplishments for her are the graduates and postgraduates of MCON. Manipal, who make her feel contented and happy as a teacher and an administrator. It is with immense pride that we felicitate Dr. Anis George for her incredible contribution in the promotion of research in yoga. We wish her a blissful and prosperous life. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Indira ma'am, for doing the honor. When I waste minutes, hours take revenge. Now, I would like to call upon our honorable and dignified Pro-Chancellor, Dr. H.S. Ballal, to give the presidential address.
My dear friends, I am very happy to be part of this 8th International Yoga Day. First of all, I would like to congratulate two dignitaries who have been honored just now. Nalini Bhaskaranand, pediatrician of great repute, who has been working with us for a very, very long period of time. Congratulations, Nalini. Please sit down. It is very good that is she is using this practice in from children, for child, you know. Once she inculcates that habit in the children, naturally it will go for the rest of the life. Because today we know yoga is very, very important for all the diseases, prevention, even eco-friendly, they say. So good, congratulations. Then the next important person is Anis, nursing boss. She was the nursing boss for a very long period of time. Again, very good. I always say nurses spend more time with the patients rather than doctors. So they will have great influence on this yoga practice on the patients, which again is very, very good. Congratulations to both of you. You richly deserve this honor. Now, I prepared a big note thinking that I will read out, but whatever I wanted to tell my vice chancellor has already said. I don't want to repeat that anyway. Now, I was watching the television this morning about our Prime Minister, you know, because this is his brainchild. Started in 2015, it has become very, very popular in the international community today. Now, along with the Prime Minister, he's very fit. I have seen my Chief Minister, Basavaraj Bommai, you know, he finds it difficult to walk and all, but he was still practicing yoga along with the Prime Minister. And I see here PLNG Rao. You know, he must have done yoga because he is not wearing the shoes. I'm sure because recently I saw one WhatsApp message going all around the place. Devi Shetty, our cardiologist of great repute, he was our old student. He was telling he had some knee pain or something like that, which was not going. Initially he neglected it, and ultimately it became so bad that he was not able to stand and all. Then his wife called a yoga teacher, and then within 3 months, it has completely disappeared. Now he can't say which joint he had pain. So I thought PLNG also had some problem. And also Basavaraj Bommai, he has severe problem. You can make out, that waddling gait when they walk, because our orthopedic boss is here. So yoga is supposed to help everything. And our HOD of yoga just now said that yoga practice is important for humanity. Non-violence, truth, and ethical practice. It's important in inculcating that which distinguishes human beings from animals, which is very, very good. So it has all-round effect, yoga. And also, we are giving a lot of importance. Our Prime Minister is very fond of alternate medicine, holistic medicine. That's why we have brought yoga under CIMR now. Isn't it? Comprehensive, integrated medical research. It was part of Kasturba Medical College initially. So we are including Ayurveda. Our Ayurveda boss is there. Basavaraj Hadpad is there. We have a very good Ayurveda department where we get a lot of patients, I consider all these specialties, Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha, Homeopathy, Yoga, as well as Allopathy medicine, are not substitutes to another. They are complementary to each other. Each has its own advantage and disadvantage. That's why yoga practice is very, very important. And our Vice Chancellor mentioned about that it is useful in, it is eco-friendly also. They have what is called as eco-yoga. It is rooted for the secret of natural evolution. They say eco-yoga, by transferring conventional yoga into eco-yoga, we can get rid of all environmental catastrophes as well as socio-cultural crises. Now today we talk about the global warming, increased carbon emission or carbon imprint being increased and all. Yoga plays a very, very important in resolving that issue also. So it's a very, very powerful tool in the overall development of the entire human being. So it's very important that we should practice right from the beginning. Those who have not started, here I see my special children also. Jai Vital is there, his leader. Because they have come here, which is very important. We must involve all sections of the society, right from children, which Nalini is doing, till the elderly people, and it will go a long way in improving the quality of life that we lead. See, all of us born in this planet have to die one day or the other. But the quality of life that we lead till the death or till we breathe last is very, very important. Then only it is worth living. I strongly feel yoga will go a long way in improving the quality of life. So I should compliment the yoga division headed by Annapurna and her team, for organizing this event every year. They have done it even in the past when the COVID was at its peak, that basically to inculcate or send a message to the public that yoga is very, very important even in preventing the COVID, because it helps in prevention of diseases. I always say prevention is better than cure and much cheaper. So yoga plays a major role in prevention of diseases. So I'm very happy that 21st of every month, the longest day, that's what Venkatraya, he's an encyclopedia, he was telling, it is decided because it's the longest day of the year. So it is celebrated, the brainchild of our Honorable Prime Minister, and I should compliment Annapurna and her team for organizing this event, and you should continue to do this every year and see, and more people are involved in that. Please sit down. So I compliment, congratulate you, and I wish this Yoga Day every success, and I'm sure all of us will get the benefit out of this. So I conclude by thanking Annapurna and her team for giving me and my wife. She said I should not mention about her, but I have to mention because she has been felicitated two big guns today. So I congratulate or thank the yoga division for giving me and my wife an opportunity to be part of this yoga day. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thank you, sir, for your continuous support. And I should not forget, sir himself is a great practitioner of yoga and being a backbone for today's program. To conclude, vote of thanks, I, on behalf of Division of Yoga, extend a hearty vote of thanks to Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro Chancellor. Thank you for blessing us. You have blessed us with your presence. I express my gratitude to Lieutenant General M.T. Vekdish, Vice Chancellor, for his continuous support. Thank you, sir. Special thanks to Dr. M. Venkataraya Prabhu, Pro Vice Chancellor, Faculty of Health Science, who has inaugurated the Summer Yoga Camp also. Dr. P. Lanji Rao, sir, who has inaugurated the webinar. Dr. Narayan Sabahit, Dr. Sharath Rao, Dean KMC, Mrs. Indira Ballal for their continuous support and making the event a grand success. I give my special thanks to Dr. Nalini Bhaskarananda, Dr. Anis George ma'am for accepting the invitation. I express my gratitude to Dr. Satish Rao, sir, Research Director, and Dr. Vishal Bhatt, Coordinator, for their continuous support. I render my hearty thanks to Dr. Krishnanandra Prabhu, Associate Dean, KMC, Dr. Anil Rana, Director, MIT, Dr. Somashekar Bhatt, Joint Director, MIT, Colonel Prakash Chandra, Director, General Service, Dr. Avinash Shetty, MS, Dr. C.G. Muttanna, CEO. Sincere thanks to all the HODs, staff and students of various departments who are present here. I should not forget to thanks Ramananda Kini, Devi Das Kini sir, Hilda madam, Jaivita sir for hall arrangement, audio visual for their continuous support, KMC office, ad syndicate for banner and printing, media and communication, SP Kar sir, Chef on Wheel for refreshment. Thank you for their support. And lastly, our students, teaching and non-teaching staff of Division of Yoga CAMR for being the backbone of today's program. Thank you, one and all. Special thanks to Ayurveda and Siddha Medicine for their continuous support. Now, we will have a small demo from our MSc Yoga Therapy students. I request the dignitary to join us below. Thank you. I request Dr. Sharath Kumar sir to just hand over the prize to two winners who have just arrived. Maitreya, below 15 years, first prize. And Vrinda, above 15 years. Thank you, sir.
Namaste.
thank you. Thank you, one and all.